$3.06 a gallon. Yesterday, it was posted down 3 cents compared to last month. Prices at the pump typically climb in the spring, but unseasonably glut of gasoline is keeping prices low. All right, so what did we learn? Make sure your battery doesn't have corrosion. Make sure it's been tested. Have your car tested. Now, if you go in for routine oil changes, they inspect it, they look at this stuff, just make sure. Okay, you don't want to be stranded. I mean, it's going to be hotter than you know what. You don't want to be stranded out there. Now, AAA, I'll tell you, I mean, what's if you pay for the service, if you have the service for AAA, they'll come out, they'll get into your car, they'll give you a jump, they'll tow your vehicle, but it's the hassle of it happening. So, you know, make sure your tires are good. Maybe you haven't, you know, changed those tires out in a while, haven't inspected the car. I mean, we just want it to work for us, but yeah, they're right about it. The temperatures, man, I live here in Florida. That's where we do our broadcast, and I don't know where you live, but it gets warm out there. But it really is very taxing for the battery, and maybe you have a 3-year battery, maybe you have a 5-year battery. Mine always, I'm glad I have the little insurance on it, because if it goes bad before, you know, the expert, you know, what they say, you know, you bring it in, get a brand new battery. Always get a brand new battery. It's like a 2-for-1 deal. And it always serves me well. So make sure if you go get your battery, like the AutoZone, Napa, wherever you get your battery, make sure I know that Advanced Auto Parts, that's where I got my battery. Make sure that you get the battery insurance on it. It's, you know, it's a few bucks extra, but it's well worth it, especially if you're in a hotter, you know, climate. Some of you in Arizona that listen to our broadcast, you know what I'm talking about. But, man, it gets warm everywhere anyway. But if you're constantly bombarded with that, it's amazing what you'll see if you pop over. You know, because a lot of us don't. We just take it into the service station. But open, when was the last time, all right, be honest, that you opened up your engine and looked in there? Some of you don't even know what you're looking at. But look at the battery. You might have a bunch of white stuff all over the battery and corrosion. Maybe it's in a battery compartment. But look in it. And if it's corroded like that, you know, you can get, there's battery cleaners. You can clean it yourself. If you don't mind a little sticky, you can use a cola or something. We used to use a regular Coke and just pour it right over the terminals, and it eats all that stuff up, and that's great. Just think what that does to your gut, but it'll actually clean your battery terminals, and you'll be good. Something to think about, a little food for thought. Not a bad deal, right? This next story, I don't know what to make of this. You know, Donald Trump, you know, getting in and saying that he's going to build up our military and he's going to fix things. And I know you can't fix a lot of things overnight, but if you know anybody, it's flying the FA-18. Yeah, the FA-18s. I don't know if they just put a slash there, but it's FA-18s or the Hornets. The Navy Marine Corps, they're basically having problems with their fighter jets, and they use a lot of these. These are like in circulation, and there's a huge safety concern. What is it? It has to do with oxygen, the oxygen maker. When there is a breakdown of life support systems, like the so-called onboard oxygen generator system or cabin pressurization, pilots often experience what the Navy and Marine Corps call psychological episodes. And a lot of our pilots that are flying these are coming down with these psychological episodes. Okay, it's where they're not getting enough oxygen. So what happens? Your fingers start tingling. You start feeling nauseated. It's apoxia. It's basically what it's called, oxygen deficiency. And decompression sickness. And they can experience dizziness, tingling of the fingers, like I say, toes. And here's the big one, confusion. And even loss of consciousness. This is really bad news here, folks. So what they're doing is trying to help them out a little bit, where they're taking off these Hornets, is aboard some of our are vessels such as the USS Carl Vinson. They're putting decompression chambers aboard because it's happening, and they can't fix it. They don't know what's causing the problem. They're looking at it. The Navy's aware of it. They know about it. But our pilots are, you know, writing in saying, you know, we don't know if we're going to go out on one of these planes and actually return. We're not afraid of getting shot down. We're afraid we're going to run out of oxygen, or we're going to, you know, our plane's going to crash. This is like the major, major concern right now. Following a pilot protest, Vice Chief of Naval Operations Admiral Bill Morin, he ordered a 30-day review of the episodes involving the T-45s and FA-18, including how the issue were addressed. Moran promised to provide a full and open accounting of our aviation community and their families and the public. And Vice Admiral Mike Shoemaker, he's the commander over at the Naval Air Force, said that the issue was his number one safety priority. One of the Navy pilots who spoke to one of the news organizations acknowledges that the Navy is doing the best it could to address the problem. But one thing the pilots and their leadership agree on, he said, is that it's a complex problem. A Marine Corps aviation public affairs officer was telling this news agency, Fox News is who I'm talking about, it's been fewer incidences than the Navy's pilots, than the Marines, but it said that its leaders are taking this matter very seriously. Psychological events remain a top concern until we fully understand all the causal factors. And Boeing, the aircraft's manufacturer, said that it was looking into the matter. They're hearing from a lot of pilots that are flying these planes. If it isn't hard enough to go on the mission worrying about being able to get oxygen and not passing out up there in the extremities, I mean, how scary. And this affects thousands of planes. It's got our pilots really skittish, really not confident. And you can imagine thinking about going into hypoxia when you're high above on a mission. This is not too cool. I mean, I hope we'll be on the story. We're going to make sure that we get to the bottom of this to figure out what's going on with those planes. But, man, we wish nothing but safety. I mean, they're already sacrificing the ultimate for us. Least we can do is keep their planes safe and making sure their oxygen is working okay. I hope the federal government and Boeing, it'd be nice to hear the president, make that phone call and say we're handling it, because this is a big story. It's affecting a lot of pilots. And again, they need to be alert. They don't need to be starved for oxygen. Unbelievable. Rascal Flatts, they're a country group, been listening to them for years, and they've been around for many years. And basically, they're saying that their longevity in the business because they just released their 10th studio album called Back to Us is credited to younger writers to be able to keep them in the thing. And they say they have no problem with hiring young writers to be able to, you know, write relevant songs. Back to Us will officially be out, the whole album, because they release, you know, different songs out of it. We've been able to obtain a song or two to be able to play for today's show. But Back to Us is the title song off the titled album Back to Us. We're going to be playing in just a second by Shay Mooney of the rising duo Dan and Shay, a duet with 22-year-old American Idol alum Lauren Elena, and a song written by powerhouse performer Chris Stapleton. And he says, I think it's important for us to help our younger generation of country music stars and artists come along, said DeMarcus. And I think the more they have success, the more success there is for us. And it's really synergetic from that standpoint. But he joked that the band's relationship with Dan and Shay was most likely an internship more of an internship than a mentorship. I saw them in Orlando one time, and they're phenomenal. They'll be coming back to the Tampa Bay area soon, and I'll probably be able to see them in the Ford Amphitheater. But if you haven't listened to any of their music recently, I used to not be a big country fan, but their albums are excellent, tight, lyrically sound. They're great performers, and they put on a heck of a stage show. I mean, very, very talented. They've done a lot of good things for charity, and they're not very outspoken about politics. Sometimes that's good when you make music, but they do know how to make music. And let's listen to the song Back to Us, Rascal Flatts on For the People.
I don't say what I mean, I don't mean what I say. It's almost like it ain't me that keeps pushing you away. How many nights have you laid here with me feeling like I left, waking up in a stranger's bed? Don't know how I got lost, I don't know how to get back. Don't know how you haven't hit the door with your bags all packed. Every morning I hear you pray for the old me instead of waking up in a stranger's bed. I'm gonna run straight back to us, baby. No more same old someone else. Back to the one you used to love like crazy. Sun comes around again, you won't be waking up in a stranger's bed. I know I say too little, yeah, I'm gone too much. I don't even remember the last time we touched. Every night it's like you're sleeping with someone you've never met, and waking up in a stranger's bed. I remember the words that you haven't heard for so long, but they're not gone yet. I'm gonna run straight back to us, baby. No more same old someone else. Back to the one you used to love.
And For the People, along with Rascal Flatts, Back to Us. And we should play more music, shouldn't we? Music and talk on For the People. Should we do that? I guess we it could be more popular. We used to play more music. It just depends on what's going on. I mean, because it takes like 4 minutes. You could do practically a story on that. But whenever we find some good music, we'll do that. And the Rascal Flatts, you can't go wrong. Now, who says you can't do things when you're